for you, Hadaway. Got your stuff? Here's that letter for you. Marcus, give him your phone number. You want your phone number? Here's your canteen. Don't worry about it. All right, when you get yourself ready, we're going to sit down for a second. Hey, Big Bird, what's the matter?
Oh, I'll tell you what's the matter. When I left Sesame Street to come to camp, I felt sad because I was leaving home. But then when I got to camp, I started to feel happy because it was fun. But now we're leaving, and I feel sad again. But I'm kind of happy thinking I'll be home. I'm sad, then I'm happy, sad, happy. What's wrong with me, Nikki?
Nothing. Oh. Everything you're feeling is okay. It's natural.
It is? Really?
It is. Really.
Well, I'm kind of happy you told me that, because I'm still kind of sad. But because when I get home, you know, you're not going to be here anymore with me to help me. But then I'm kind of happy thinking that I'm... And then I think
attention, cabin 10! All campers up front for the cabin picture!
A cabin picture?
Cabin picture. Come on, Big Bird.
Oh,
come on.
That'll be good.
Come on, guys. Cabin picture, come on, get up here. Come on, pull in.
Okay, everybody ready? Everybody ready? Aunt May is going to turn this timer on, and then I'm going to get into the picture with you. Okay?
Okay.
Oh, boy. I'm going to have a picture of me with everybody.
Okay. Come on, tighten in,
smile!
Andy? Wait a minute. Where's Rusty?
Rusty, where are you?
All right. I'll be in the picture. Sure. You want me to be in the picture? I'll be in the picture.
Okay. Okay, campers, look sharp!
Come on, look sharp. Straighten up. Look.
I'm afraid you weren't in the picture, Annie Mae.
I know, Big Bird, I know. Oh, okay, campers, what we have here is a film crisis. We only have one shot left. So this better be good, okay?
Come on, come on, one shot in the hand.
All right, careful, Mark. Let's mess this one up. Come on. 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 Gee, look at that cloud up there. Looks just like a birthday cake. Look, up there.
Kids tough as rocks, meanest dudes on the whole block. So it may come as quite a shock that when we're feeling sad and blue,
we big kids cry boo-hoo. Yes we do. Yes we do. We big kids cry boo-hoo. Boo-hoo, why, zap, zap. Boo-hoo, why, zap, zap.
We can cry loud, we can cry low, and we want everyone to know that when you're feeling down or misunderstood, a little cry can do you good. Clear the air, cheer your mood. A little cry can do you good.
Hey guys, cheer up! Look, I got a great big box of popcorn here! Ha! Let's go to the park and eat it!
Oh, sure, right. Kid! That's great! Oh, golly! Oh, wow! Kid, you're nice for a shrimp!
Popcorn!
You know that?
Yes?
You expecting an order?
Yes. I ordered 5 tall things.
Well, here's tall thing number 1.
Oh, a ladder.
Tall thing number 2.
A giraffe.
Number 3.
A flagpole.
And the 4th?
A tree.
And tall thing number 5.
A duck. But a duck isn't tall.
Oh. Hey, Phil! Aren't you forgetting something? There you go. Five tall things.
That's a buffalo.
And now we take you to Kermit the Frog for another fast-breaking news story.
Hey, Jeff, how's the wife? Huh? She's on camera? Well, I'm on camera. hi there, Kermit the Frog of Sesame Street News, reporting to you today from the house of the three little pigs. And today we're expecting the big bad wolf to drop around. But first, Hark, I believe this is one of the three little pigs here. Pardon me, pig. Excuse me, can I ask you, Kermit the Frog of Sesame Street News, can I ask you a question or two? For instance, could you tell me what this house is built of?
Straw.
Uh-huh,
straw. Mm-hmm.
Straw. Yes, well, could you tell us exactly why you built your house out of straw?
Because mm-hmm. straw is light and mm-hmm. easy to carry, and when we get hungry, we mm-hmm. can nibble on a wall or two, even. Yeah.
Well, don't you think it would have been better to build a house out of wood or bricks or something like that?
Right.
In case somebody like, maybe a big bad wolf were to come along and huff and puff and blow the house down?
Blow this house down?
Yeah, well...
I worked 4 days on this house. This is a strong house.
Yeah, but...
Blow this house down?
Well,
blow this house down? Oh, I gotta tell the guys that. That's a good one.
Well, you...
Tears to laugh.
He seems to take the whole subject rather lightly, but... Hark! What do I see coming
I'm
now?
I'm gonna cook you
it's
for
It's a large,
supper.
Shaggy thing. Pardon me, but are you indeed the big bad wolf himself?
Oh, I am indeed.
Can you tell me exactly what you had in mind coming around here today?
Oh, yeah. Well, you see, this is where the three little pigs live.
True.
Yeah, and I got some business with them, because I'm gonna make them an offer they can't refuse.
Yeah, well, do you mind if we from Sesame Street stand around to watch?
Okay, but you better stand back.
Okay, I'll just go right over here on this tree.
Little pig, open the door.
Wait a minute, hold on, just 1 second. Just a minute, there's a tradition here. The big bad wolf is supposed to say, little pig, let me come in.
Oh, yeah.
That's the line, right?
Right. Mm-hmm. Little pig, let me come in.
By the hair of my chinny chin chin.
Somehow I thought he would say that.
Then I'll huff and I'll puff and I'll blow your house in.
Stand by, folks. Here it comes. Wow. There he goes, folks. That wolf is huffing and puffing, and it's really quite a... Good heavens, it's quite a breeze he's got going here. We'll see if he's able to blow the house down here. He's really blowing hard. You talk about a strong breath, folks. My heavens. Remember you saw it here on Sesame Street, folks. Well, as you can see, folks, the house is still standing. The wolf is still blowing. And so this is Kermit the Frog, and the wolf is now returning me to Sesame Street!
I've got a mind, and my mind helps me with everything I do. or C. My mind tells me this is a toy. It's a wind-up little boy. My mind knows how to make him run. Just turn the key. Boy, this is fun. When he's wound up, good and tight, put him down and watch him, bite! I should have given him a wind-up sandwich.
Rusty, what are you doing here? Aunt May's gonna give out the awards now. Don't you want to go?
Nah, who wants to watch somebody give out awards?
Big Bird,
what's an award?
Well, an award is like a prize. They give it to kids who do things really good at camp. And then they have a ceremony and everything. Why, I might get one and you might get one too.
Me?
Yeah.
Nah, I won't get an award. No, I don't take awards, even when they're given to me.
Why not? If you get an award for something you did, you can feel proud.
Hey, I can feel proud without an award. I don't need an award to know that I did something good.
Yeah, but it would still be nice to get an award anyway, wouldn't it?
Nah. Awards don't mean nothing to me.
Well, I hope I get one. So, come on, huh?
Oh, all right. If you want me to go to the awards with you, I'll go to the awards
with
you.
Okay. Come on. Let's get going.
The Echo Rock Most Organized Award goes to Al Hislip. The award for Best Letter Writer goes to Norman Stahl. Nutrition goes to Joe Billy. And now the Echo Rock Swimming Award goes to Big Bird.
Hey, I just hope I get one. Oh, I hope I get one.
Go, stretch your stump. Go.
Big Bird. Big Bird.
Go.
I get one. Oh, hey.
Hey, I stuck in the tent with him.
No, I'd get one.
You got
I was
one.
Hoping I'd get one. And here I am. I've got one. I'm going to get an award.
I'm going to get an award. A big red gold award.
Oh, boy. Oh, wow, this is better than an Emmy. Oh, gosh.
And now, last but not least, the Camp Echo Rock Good Sport Award. This award goes to the camper who was asked to do things he really didn't want to do, but he did them anyway. The Camp Echo Rock Good Sport Award goes to Russell Edmund Wingate III.
Who's that?
I usually don't take awards, but if Aunt May wants to give me an award, sure, I'll take an award. That's the kind of guy I am.
Yeah.
Put it there.
No, I don't take applause. No, never applause.
Now let's hear it for all the Camp Echo Rock Award winners. Hip, hip!
Hooray!
I can't hear ya! Hip, hip!
Hooray!
Hip, hip!
Hooray!
Five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
presenting the further adventures of everybody's favorite hero, the man who is faster than lightning, stronger than steel, smarter than a speeding bullet. It's Super Grover!
And I am Choo-Choo!
And now, on to our story.
Yes, on to our story!
One day, Super Grover was flying high over Metro City when suddenly, down below in Max's barbershop, he heard little Willy Nilly crying.
No, I won't get a haircut.
But, Willy, you know that your mother wants you to get a haircut.
I don't care. Hark! What is that sound?
It's a bird.
A plane.
It's... It's Super Grover.
Are you all right, Super Grover?
I certainly hope so. We superheroes bruise easily, you know.
But Super Grover, what is the reason for you to drop in on us like this?
Super Grover heard a little child crying.
That was me. Huh? I don't want to get a haircut.
Well, why don't you want to get a haircut, little boy?
Because it will hurt.
Hurt? Hurt? Of course it will hurt. But you must be brave. You must smile through your tears. You must endure the agony, bear the pain, ignore the elfishness.
Willie, haircuts don't hurt.
It doesn't
hurt to cut hair. Look, let me show you. I'll just cut a little piece of my own here. Now watch this. Watch closely. See that? There. See?
Did you see that? He cut his own hair and he did not even cry out in agony. What a brave, brave man.
Didn't that hurt?
No, Willie, it didn't hurt at all. Look, let me show you. Here, just hold still now. Okay, and... There, see that?
Look at that! I do not believe it! That little boy did not even scream out in pain when his hair was cut. How come is that?
Because it didn't hurt.
Sure. You see, Grover? Come here a moment now.
What?
Grover, now just...
Well, no, just don't, hold, don't, please!
Just hold
don't
still a moment
hair.
There, Grover.
Please don't cut my fur! Please don't do it!
There.
Please don't do it!
Grover, look at this. Please. That's a little piece of your fur.
You cut my fur?
Mm-hmm, just a little bit.
I did not even feel it.
Sure.
You did not hurt me. Except
sure.
I kind of felt a woofly feeling on my head. It's kind of nice.
I told you haircuts don't hurt. You ready for your haircut now, Willie?
Yeah, maybe
okay.
That'll be fun.
Hold still.
Well, it looks like Super Grover, noble hero of heroes, has done it again. I have made a great discovery. Haircuts do not hurt. No, and I must spread the word throughout the land. Haircuts do not hurt. Up, up. And away! My cape is caught on the hook.
Tune in next time when you will hear Super Grover say...
Haircuts do not hurt, but crashing through doors is quite painful. Oh, boy. Whew.
Long suspenders. Longer. Longest.
You came in here a bunch of rockheads!
goodbye, country, goodbye. Beautiful trees to climb all over, oodles of bees and lots of clover, living outdoors under a shining sky. Oh, country, goodbye, country, goodbye. Goodbye, country, goodbye. Mountains to climb and lakes to dip in, fireflies winking, raindrops dripping, catching a frog, watching a butterfly. Oh, country, goodbye, country, goodbye. Days when you lie and watch a cloud sail over, night when you count each star that's in the sky. Water is clearer, air is cleaner, heaven is nearer, grass is greener, living is sweet, sweet as a honeycomb. Oh, gee, country, I wish I could take you back home. Oh, gee, country, I wish I could take you back home.
Hey, Aunt May, one last shake.
How about another hug?
W. Wallpaper. W.
Oh, the missus and I had a wonderful time.
All right, everybody, settle down. Come on now. Welcome to the weekly meeting of the National Association of W Lovers. We are gathered here today to pay tribute to that great letter W and the wondrous sound it makes. Ooh, isn't that lovely?
Ooh. That is
yeah, it makes the heart pound faster. All right, now, if you'll all turn to page 4 in the manual, we will sing the club song. All right, turn to page 4. That's it. All right, now, everybody ready? Here we go. I'll begin. You can join in later. Here we go. Ah, what is the letter we love? What sound are we extra fond of? It's not any trouble, you know it's a W when you hear woo, 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 woo. Without this fine letter, you couldn't say wash or witch, wax, or wiggle. My gosh. There wouldn't be wet, warm, or walrus. Oh, wow. There wouldn't be wood. Would there now? Without this great W sound, well, wink would be ink, and weak would be eek. Don't you see? Of course. A fine word like waffle would turn out just awful. Oh, W's grand as can be. All right, everybody.
So what is the letter we love? The sound of your fond of. It's not any trouble, you know it's a W when you hear woof, 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 woof.
One more time.
When you hear woof, 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 woof.
Oh, wow, that was wonderful.
Hi, you know, I've got something I'm going to show. About a letter you should know. It starts up here and goes down there and right back up in the air. Then down you go and up again, till I say whoa. Whoa! Okay, this neat letter is capital W. Now that you know it, it shouldn't trouble you. Now the capital W is a boss-looking letter. I can't think of another one better. Can you? You got 2 seconds.
Cats have kittens. Doggies have pups. horses have pretty foals, and sheep have lambs. Cows have calves, and I bet you didn't know that elephants have calves too. Lions and leopards have cubs, which is the proper thing for them to do. Peacocks have chicks, deer have fawns, ducks have ducklings, often padding round on lawns. Pigs have piglets, and in case you didn't know, I've another fact for you. Goats have kids, like people have kids, like me and you.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H.
Whoa, 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 what are you doing?
I was reciting the alphabet.
Oh, I see.
Ahem. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O.
What's an alphabet?
You don't know what the alphabet is?
Oh, yeah. A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
Do you know what it's for?
Yes.
P, Q, R, S, T, U, V.
What?
What? What?
The alphabet what?
The alphabet is all the letters from A to Z.
Oh.
We use them all to read and spell and write.
Oh.
Now, may I continue?
Please do.
Thank you very much. W, X, Y, Z. You got it?
Yeah. How does it start again?
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z.
I'm almost there. Now, one more time, please. Oh, I got it.
You know what I like best of all in the world?
What?
It's a hug. Would you do that for me? Would you hug me?
Yeah.
Well, squeeze real tight, real tight. Real tight. Oh, that's good. I love hugs. Now, could you do one more thing for me?
What?
What I really love in the world is scratching my tummy. Would you scratch my tummy? Oh, this is so good! Oh, scratch a little higher. Oh, this is... Oh, you've made the monster very happy. Huh? Little tummy scratching never hurt.
Ah, a sign. Oh, boy. Walk tall. Walk tall. 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 Okay. Walk. 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 Walk tall.
Well, that's easy for you to say. I'm lucky if I can crawl tall.
Walk tall.
Hey, Stevie.
Huh?
You're so good. Can you sing a long note?
Long note?
A long note.
Okay, I have to take a deep breath to sing a long note.
Go ahead. That was not long.
I gotta try.
Oh, you didn't do it yet. Okay. Oh, that's good. It's good, Stevie. Okay, Stevie. I get the idea. Good. Boy, that took a lot out of you.
That's right.
Okay, I'm going to sing you a long note now, okay?
Okay, you want the key?
Oh, sure.
Yeah, okay. Okay. You gotta have the key.
Here we go.
Girl. Hey, girl. I tell you what.
What?
You sing a short note.
Me sing a short note? Stevie
right.
Wonder wants me to sing
That's
a
right.
short note.
I want you to sing a short
I'm going to tell everybody. I I am the short note singer! Woo!
What's he excited about? Oh, about his car. It's short. Hey, what's going on here? No, it's long. Short. Long. Short. Long. And away they go. But not far. I think the car is going to be short again. Very. Watch out! Short.
V. This is a vase that I'll put in this vat away from the villain in the Panama hat.
I am the villain in the Panama hat, and I'm after that vase that's here in this vat. I'll fill it with vinegar and throw in some varnish. And top that all off with some violets garnish. And now I will slip it here under my vest.
Oh, no, you don't, villain. You're under arrest. V.
You know something, David?
What?
I really miss Big Bird since he went away to camp.
Yeah, you know? I miss him, too. You know what I miss? I really miss his,
Hey, everybody!
He's funny, you know? Yeah. Well, he was going to be back pretty soon anyway.
That's right.
Yeah.
You know what we ought to do?
What?
We ought to surprise him. I think we ought to go over to the nest.
Yeah?
We ought to clean it up, sparkling clean, you know? And that'll be his big surprise.
That's a great idea.
Yeah.
And, we could do something. You know, when I was really young, my brother and I made a big welcome home sign for my dad. He was away for a couple of days, and he loved it. Why don't we make that for Big Bird, okay?
He'd love it. Let's do that. Let's do
okay,
it.
Come on, let's go do it.
Okay.
Hey, oh, hi. Hey, fellas, what's happening?
Oh, David's got a great idea.
Listen, okay, this is terrific. What we're going to do is we're going to go over to the nest, and we're going to clean up the nest, sparkling clean.
Yeah.
Yeah. And we're going to make a big sign that says, Welcome Home, Big Bird.
What surprise him. Let him know we're really, really happy he's back.
Yeah, huh? I like it. I like it.
All right?
I'll tell you what. I'll go get my broom and my dustpan and...
Okay.
Okay.
I'll get some dust rag. I'll be right back.
I got a big card and some pen.
What? Yeah.
Oh, won't Bird be surprised when he comes home and finds his nest all cleaned up and this welcome home sign? I can't wait. He is going to love it.
You're kidding.
No, this place looks pretty clean already.
Yeah, it sure does. It looks like it was just dusted.
Yeah.
Hey, look at the sign. Welcome home, Big Bird. Mr. S?
Oh, come on, Bob. You're trying to put us on.
Come on.
You came in here and made this sign, and you're trying to make us think that it's Mr. Snuffleupagus.
Are you kidding? Come on, I wouldn't do that.
Bob, we weren't born yesterday.
Hold on, wait a minute now. You think I came in and did this by myself?
Well, if you didn't do it, who did?
I don't know.
You.
No, I didn't do it. Yeah, are you?
No, I didn't do it.
How about you? Did you do it?
Did you come in here and clean up Big Bird's nest and put up that sign?
Mr. Snuffleupagus? No.
No!
It's measuring.
I didn't imagine that.
But
you know something? There was that time I had a hard time.
I wondered about this thing. Big Bird was answering.
Really, I could never figure
Wimple went a boatin', making dirty water gear, pouring stuff there till the gunk was everywhere. Now if every kid did it, can't you see what an icky mess it would be? No place for fish to swim, no lakes for sailing in, no rivers, no streams, no submarines, no swimming ever again. Now if every kid did it, can't you see what an icky mess see. No fun world it would be. Yuck.
It's a whale. That's his back. The back of his body. He's breathing air.
If he's breathing air, he's not a fish.
He's surviving in the ocean. There he goes. He's diving.
Yeah, he's looking for fish.
That's his tail.
He's coming up with his mouth full of fish.
He has a real big body.
As big as a bus. Sometimes two whales jump out of the water together.
What's that sound?
The whales are talking to each other.
Here comes a mother and her baby.
Well, I think they look like big cucumbers, but they should be really the fish.
But they're whales.
I think they're friendly.
W.
Huh. Why?
Wall.
Hmm? Hmm.
Sesame Street, hey everybody! Here I am, I'm back! Oh gosh, Rusty, I'm afraid it's time to say goodbye, for real now.
No, not if this is your neighborhood.
Oh sure, this is my neighborhood, I live on Sesame Street.
Well, I live right around the corner.
You do?
Yeah.
Oh, Rusty, that means we could see each other if we want to, anytime we want.
Yeah, sure, if you want to see each other.
Of course I want us to see each other.
Yeah, of course. Okay, well, see you, buddy. Take care.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Gosh.
Gee.
Here's your duffel bag, Big Bird.
Oh, thank you, Ricky.
That's Mickey,
Mickey
Big Bird.
Do you by any chance live right around the corner, too?
No, I'm afraid not.
Oh.
I live in Cleveland, and that's a long way from here.
It is, huh? Oh, well, then why don't you just stay? This is a nice neighborhood.
Well, I know it probably is, but my family's from Cleveland, and I miss them, too, and I want to see them.
Oh, okay, yeah. Well, I'm sure gonna miss you, Mickey.
I'm gonna miss you, too, Big Bird.
Oh, maybe I'll see you next year at camp, huh?
I really hope so.
Okay.
Bye, Big Bird.
No, bye. Bye, Mickey, bye, Rusty, bye, Debbie, bye, Mitch, bye, Russell, bye. Oh, gee, I'm gone.
Agua.
Greetings. I am the Count. They call me the Count because I love to count things.
Cookie Monster. They call me that because me love to eat cookies. Cookies! Oh, me eat.
No, I will count them.
No, me eat them.
Count.
Eat.
No, count.
Eat.
Count.
Eat.
Count.
Eat.
Wait.
What?
Why don't we cooperate?
You mean?
Yes. I will count the cookies, and you will eat them.
Count?
Yes?
Count.
My pleasure. One. Two. Three. Seven cookies! Counting!
Oh, cookies!
I wonder what would happen if I sneaked up behind Donald and popped this balloon. That would scare him and his dog. And what would happen if I pop this balloon? Yeah! And it does scare him and his dog. The dog might pull Donald away on his skateboard. That would be funny. And what would happen if I pop this balloon? And it scared Donald and his dog. And the dog does pull Donald away on his skateboard. Ooh, Donald and his dog might get hurt. And that wouldn't be funny at all. Here, Donald, I want to give you this balloon.
Oh, thanks, Linda. It's really nice of you to think of me.
Oh, that's all right, Donald.
Listen, why don't we go to Mr. Hooper's and celebrate?
Yeah, you can tell us all about camp.
Oh, okay. But let me just put my things away and I'll be right with you, okay?
Okay, well, we'll meet you over there.
Oh, that's a good idea. Okay. See you at Mr. Hooper's. Snuffy.
Oh.
Is that you?
It's me. Is it you, Bird?
Yes, Snuff.
The answer is bus.
What?
Remember the guessing game we played the day you left for camp? I was supposed to guess how you were going to get there,
yeah.
And I did. The answer is bus.
You're right, you're right, you're right, you win.
I have one for you now, Bird.
Oh.
What is it that's good for friends to do when they haven't seen each other for a long time?
Oh, I think I know.
Oh.
They hug. A big hug. Oh,
you got it right, Bird.
Oh. And Snuff, look what you've done. You made a big sign for me and you spiffed the whole place up. It's great. Oh, Snuff, what a buddy.
¿Qué es esto? Un cuadrado. ¿Y qué es esto? Un círculo. ¿Y esto?
un triángulo. ¿Y qué es esto? Un rectángulo. Cuadrado. Círculo. Triángulo. Rectángulo.
And the mama pigeon said, someone's been eating my bird seed. And the baby pigeon said, someone's been eating my bird seed, and ate it all up.
Hey, Bert. Bert, I just learned a terrific new game. You want to learn to play the game?
Well, I'm reading right now.
It's a pretending game, Bert, though. You'll really like it.
Yeah, and, well, some other
called,
time.
No, it's called Guess What I Am, Bert. You want to play?
No.
Okay, tell you what, put down the book, Bert.
And, here's the way
we play the game, Bert. You ready? Now, I first pretend to be something, and you have to guess what it is that I'm pretending to be. You ready?
Yeah.
Okay, now try to guess what this is. You ready? Here we go. Roo, 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 roo.
All right, it's a dog, it's a dog.
Oh, very good, Bert.
Yeah.
Very good. That's one for you, Bert.
Yeah.
Now, here's what we do next. I do another one. You ready, Bert? Guess what I am this
it's
time.
It's not over. That's it. That's
no. Oh. Guess what I am this time. Here we go. Quack, quack. Quack, quack.
You're silly.
No. Guess what I am, Bert. Quack,
you're
quack.
A duck.
A duck.
You're a duck.
Very good, Bert. You got them both.
All right, let me read
That's
now.
Wonderful. No. Now it's your turn, Bert.
What do you mean?
No, now you have to pretend to be something, and I get to guess what it is that you're pretending to be.
Ernie. All right, let's get it over with.
Okay, Bert.
I'll get off the chair there. Let's see,
okay.
What do I... I know what. Ready?
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
Toot, toot, chugga, 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 toot, toot.
Yeah? Oh, I'm not sure, Bert. Do a little bit more of it.
Okay. Chugga, chugga, toot, toot, chugga, 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 chugga.
I think I get the idea, but do a little bit more, Bert. I'm not real sure.
All right.
Oh, there you are, you pesky train, you.
Wait a minute, get off my back. I'm no train.
You're not a train, Bert?
Oh, yeah, I am a train. That's
I
it,
knew you were a train all along. Can't fool me. All aboard!
So do a little bit more of it there, Bert.
Next up, Kookaburra!
Wait a minute. What's going on?
Oh, you're a good train, Bert.
Is this your hobby game? I like the game. Come on, we're going to get off. Hey, you guys!
W.
Wow, and then what did you do, Bert?
Well, it was really great, Snuffy. We learned how to swim, and I learned so well. Look, I won a swimming award.
Gosh.
Huh?
Wow.
Oh, it was wonderful.
I can imagine. Oh, Bert, do you think that next year maybe I could go to camp?
Oh, that would be wonderful. Yeah. Oh, we'll have to look into that. Because you know what else they had?
What?
They had all these...
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters V and W and by the number 5. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
Ha 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 ha!